Precious friends, precious family, how are you doing today? God loves you. Jesus loves you. I love you. I thank and praise God for this wonderful opportunity to share God's word with you even today. Present or future, now or later, earth or heaven, man or God, these are very, very challenging, disturbing questions. The choice is ours. Brother, sister, my friend, God will never ever force anyone for anything until we breathe our last. Got it? Until we live, God will never ever force anyone for anything. In the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, verse 24 through 27, we read like this. By faith, Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season, esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt, for he had respect unto the recompense of the reward. By faith he forsook Egypt, not fearing wrath of the king, for he endured as seeing God himself, who is invisible. Got it? See, here we read about Moses. He was supposed to be the next king of Egypt, but he had a choice. He had a choice. He said no to that great, awesome opportunity, worldly opportunity. And he said yes to God. He said no to the world, and he said yes to God. And he chose to suffer rather than enjoying the pleasures of the palace for a season. My brother, my sister, my friend, our life on earth is for a very short while. It's for a very short while. Everything is a choice. You can choose to follow the world, follow the devil, follow the pleasures of the world. It's a choice. Or you can choose to suffer for Christ for a while. It's a choice. If you want to live in the now world, you will lose the later world. If you want to enjoy the present, you will lose the future. If you want to enjoy the earthly life, you will lose the heavenly life. If you want to please man, you will lose God. Simple, simple, simple. It's a choice. God will never ever force anyone until we die. He respects our choices, our decisions. He respects that. And he keeps quiet. The day will come, we may not be able to talk, but God will do the talking. That will be on the day of judgment. You see, in the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verse 24, we read like this. No man can two serve masters. No man can serve two masters. Who is telling? God is telling. We cannot serve God and mammon. We cannot serve God and money. We cannot serve God and devil. We cannot serve God and world. We cannot do these things simultaneously. We have to choose either one of that. God or world. God or money. God or devil. God or man. We have to make the choice. This is an individual choice, my brother, my sister, my friend. We can fool around people, but not God. God knows the depth of our hearts. God knows our intentions. God knows our motives. God knows our secret plans deep down our heart. God knows which is, what is our top priority. Him or money. Him or world. Him or devil. Him or man. God knows exactly. And God is talking to you to make the right choice. Moses did that. Moses stood with God. Moses said, Lord, I will stand with you. I don't need this palace. I don't need this, these pleasures of the palace. And he said, it's for a short while, but whereas with God for eternity. He took the right choice. He said, I would rather suffer with the people of God than to be called the king of Egypt and to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a while. Right choice, great choice, wise choice, eternal choice. Brother, sister, my friend, think about that. How great, how wonderful opportunity right in front of him. But he said, no. Wise choice. You see, in the book of Luke, chapter 16, verse 15, God says like this, what is highly esteemed in the sight of man is an abomination to God. You got it? God says that. Jesus says that. What is highly esteemed in the sight of man is an abomination to God. Think about it. There are so many people running behind the world, man, devil, just man pleasers, world pleasers. And God says that it is an abomination in the sight of God. Wake up. In the book of John, chapter 4, verse 4, God says that friendship with the world is enmity with God. You got it? Friendship with the world is enmity with God. Of course, we are all in the world. We are living in the world now. But you should know your limits. That's the point. You should not exceed. You should not cross. You should not violate the word of God. In the book of 1 John, chapter 2, verse 15, God says this, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man, he says that, if any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. You got it? Cross-check. Self-examine. In case, if you are loving the world, loving the materials in the world, God says that the love of the Father is not in you. If I do love the world, God says it, I don't have the love of the Father in me. You got it? How dangerous that would be. God is warning you. God loves you. Jesus loves you. That is the reason God is reaching you and talking to you and giving you wisdom this morning. Wake up, my friend. Wake up. The book of John 17, verse 16, God says that we are in the world, but we are not of the world. Jesus said that. We are in the world, but we are not of the world. You got it? And the Bible says it very clearly. In Philippians chapter 3, verse 20, our conversation is in heaven. You got it? God did not just leave us like that. You got it? God did not leave us to the mercy of the world. He said that I have prepared something awesome for you, which is in heaven, a long home, a permanent, eternal home in heaven, not handmade, God-made. You got it? In order to go over there, we need to be prepared. Yes. Even for small little things, how much we need to qualify. Then think about a life in heaven without tears, without pains, without sorrows, without death. A life of joy and peace forever and ever and ever and ever with God. How wonderful that would be. Get prepared for that. Be prepared for that. The simple thing is this, if you receive Lord Jesus as your personal Savior, as I did, and if you take immersion baptism and receive the Holy Spirit as I received, and if you continue to live a holy life, if you try to live a holy life, we are all sinners, we all have our own shortcomings, our own weakness and wickedness and shortcomings. We are all human beings. We are all flesh. We depend on God. It is God's grace which sustains us, which gives us a strength in our weakness. You got it? My brother, my sister, my friend, make the right choice. Stand with God. Stand with Jesus. Live for God. Live for Jesus. The day will come. Jesus will receive you. God will receive you because you stood for Him. You got it? God cannot be unjust. So make a choice today, the right choice today. Receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. And take immersion baptism. And try to live a holy life according to the Holy Bible. Read the Bible. Believe the Bible. Obey the Bible. Nothing like it. God said, heaven and earth will pass away, but not my word. You got it? Bible will never ever pass away. And if you stick on to that, God will stick on to you. You honor God. God will honor you. Simple. What you sow, what you reap. You got it? It's a choice, my brother. Choice, my sister. Choice, my friend. God gave a wonderful example. Moses had the opportunity of becoming the next king of Egypt. He said no. And he chose to suffer with the people of God because he saw the future in heaven. We have an awesome future in heaven. Wonderful future in heaven. These tears, these pains, these sorrows, and final death. This is for the earth. But in heaven, it won't be there, my brother, my sister, my friend. We need to be prepared for that. God loves you. Jesus loves you. I love you. Until we meet again, may God be with you all. Amen. Hallelujah.